Welcome back to Let's Play Fire Emblem Path of Radiance. Last time, Chapter 4. This time, Chapter 5, Flight. You know the saying, fire, flight? That's basically where this is from, although there's no real fight. Father, brother, it's that lady Ike rescued. She's awake. Really? Come on, let's greet our guest. Gorilla has a big ass nose, yo. So how are you feeling?
I'm fine. You are?
The name's Grail. I'm the commander of this mercenary company.
My lord Grail, you're the one who came to my aid, are you not? I don't know how to thank you.
Hold on. The one who found you and brought you here is my son, Ike. If you want to thank someone, thank him.
No, please, that's not... Lord Ike, was it? You have my gratitude.
Pardon my bluntness, but I have some questions for you. Tell me, who are you? What were you doing in that place?
The place where Ike found you was evidently the site of a fierce battle between Crimean and Daein soldiers.
Do you have some relation to the Crimean royal family?
I make no promises, but we may be able to help you. Will you share your story with us? You took me in and cared for me. I will place my trust in you. My name is Elincia Riddell Crimea. I'm the daughter of King Roman of Crimea.
What? You say you're the princess of Crimea?
Yes.
That's an odd claim to make. I never heard of King Crimea having any children.
That is to be expected. My heritage, my very existence, has never been made public.
Why is that?
To avoid national turmoil. You see, I was born after my uncle Lord Raining was named successor to the throne, so...
They kept you a secret to avert a possible blood feud, yes. I'm willing to accept that for the time being.
Very well then. Let's suppose that you truly are Princess Crimea. You must know it's become the king and your uncle.
I like to hear that news.
My father and mother are dead. They fell at the hands of Ashnar, King of Daein. My lord uncle and the royal knights are still battling the Daein army, I believe.
See.
I fled the castle to follow my lord uncle's orders and seek refuge in the kingdom of Gallia.
In Gallia?
Yes. We believe that King Caeneus would grant me sanctuary, so that's where I was going. But we were discovered by Daein troops, and I lost my escort of knights. My life, the life I have now, was purchased with the blood of those brave knights.
Does King Daein know of your existence?
Yes. I was told the royals of each nation were informed of my identity in the event of dire circumstances.
If that's the case, they must be searching frantically for you.
Master Grail, my lord Ike, you said that you were mercenaries, did you not? Please, would you help me gain Gallia? I beg of you, I have no one. No one else to turn to.
Princess Crimea, truly? Father spoke to her as if he believed her were telling the truth.
I see.
What is it, Titania?
It's nothing. I was just remembering something from the past.
From the past? Back when you were a Crimean royal knight?
What? How'd you know about that?
A long time ago, I heard Shino and the others talking about it.
They keep such loose tongues.
Was it a secret?
No, it wasn't, but much like I have more experience than you, I also have more things to worry about.
Like Princess Crimea.
Well, yes, I myself was unaware of the princess's existence, but now that I think about it, she does bear a striking resemblance to both the king and queen.
So she probably is a true princess. I wonder what Father will do. Will he take on her request?
We've got trouble! Outside there are soldiers! A lot of them! What?
Oh, yep, there are the soldiers. Is everyone here?
Yes.
Commander, what are the Daein dogs saying? Shinova Princess Crimea will leave the area immediately. Comply now or we will attack. Pretty straightforward. What are we gonna do? That's what we were here to decide.
One thing's been made clear by the arrival of our friends outside.
So, I would say this confirms her identity as Princess Crimea, wouldn't you?
Yes, but what do we do now?
I'd like to hear the opinion of everyone here.
Titania, I'd like to hear from you first.
The blame for this war rests on Daein. If we ally ourselves with them, the company's reputation will surely suffer. Conversely, if we deliver Princess Crimea safely, our stock will rise in the eyes of our primary employers. The road is clear.
Soren?
There's nothing to think about. We must deliver to Princess Daein immediately.
Even if Crimea is in the right.
We are mercenaries. Our actions are dictated only by our self-interest. If we want to ensure our future, we need Daein in our debt. They will win this war after all, and nothing else will serve us better.
Juno, Gatry.
Zoran's a pompous superior whelp, but he's got the right idea.
Besides destination Scalia, so it's a moot question.
I don't care how much we get paid. There's no way under this I'm going to that stinking beast country.
Princess Alencia, she does possess a certain regal beauty.
There's a lot to be said for that, you know.
However, I do prefer country girls. They're a bit cuter and not quite so standoffish, so
forget I said that.
What you decide is good for me, Commander.
Yep.
Oscar, Boyd?
I agree with Captain Titania. If we turn Princess over to Daein Army, we're essentially giving them permission to kill her. I'm in favor of helping her. That's what heroes are supposed to do.
Well, Reese?
I believe that none of this hinges on whether she's a princess or not. Refusing to aid someone in need is not something we should ever do. That's what I think.
That's right. Let's help her. Please, we have to help her.
And what about you, Ike?
I agree with Titania. I say we help her and take her to Galia.
I see. I think I know where you all stand.
Well then, here's my decision.
We escort the princess to Galia.
Are you sure that's for the best, Father?
Yes. Besides, I think the choice has been taken out of our hands.
What?
Open your eyes and listen. Listen, all of you.
Huh? What is it?
Uh-oh. I don't hear a thing.
Idiots, that's the problem. Don't you think it's a bit odd? Complete silence in all four directions?
Oh, so that's what you're talking about.
Not only are the animals quiet, but the bugs are silent too. And that is unnatural beyond belief, which means we're surrounded. The soldiers aren't waiting for an answer. They already decided to attack. It would appear they had no intention of keeping their side of the proposed bargain. They're planning on lulling us out into a false security and destroying every one of us.
Probably so, but the deal is, we're not so naive or experienced as to fall for their trap. Everyone, take your positions. We're going to settle this right now.
I'll go and hold the rear entrance.
Ike, you're in command here. Don't let the enemy take the front.
Got it. Be careful, Commander.
I'll give it a shot.
Reporting in, sir. The mercenaries have taken up arms and formed up in the bailey.
So they sniffed out our little plot, have they? Which means they're not an opponent that will be easily fooled. We'll need something special.
Shall we continue with the planned attack?
No, Princess Crimea is somewhere within that fort.
If we use flaming arrows to try and smoke them out, we might bring harm to the princess.
We've been told to do our best to deliver her alive and uninjured. It would be preferable if they were come out on their own accord.
They do slay all but the princess.
Yes, sir.
As you could tell from the fading, somebody died. I'm not gonna name names, but Boyd. Boyd died in part 8. So I have to redo the rest of this part and redo part 8. I wish I could save in between chapters. Believe me, I wish I could, but I can't. But
Chapter 5. This is a defending mission, and one thing to note that on hard mode, this actually has a fog of war setting, meaning there is fog and you literally don't know what's coming towards you. So that means you would have to take a more cautious approach in terms of defending. However, in normal and easy modes, you don't have to worry about that. Thank goodness for that, because I like knowing where my enemies are, and fog of war, I feel like it's only really done well in the handheld games, not so much the console ones. If mainly because console games are, well, on a big screen TV, and having a fog of war would more or less distract me in numerous ways. And I would like Reese over here to attack these nice... That's Oscar, not Reese. What? Why do I think Reese is Oscar? Oscar, you fool! Why? Why do you fail me, Oscar? I love you. Don't fail me. Is really all I could possibly say. Gatry, I'm gonna send you down here. You're way too slow. Move Titanian down there. Shinon, go over there. Iron Bow, because I have a feeling you're gonna get a critical anyway. So just stay down there, right in that corner, unless needed to go over to the left side. At the very least, you don't have to guard anything on the right-hand side, which is a glorious thing to behold, because I'd rather not have to worry about three fronts when I have only about, like, 10 dudes. I'm hoping tonight, it's May 25th now, by the time this actually gets uploaded, probably gonna be June. No, it is gonna be June, probably late June, but I don't want to be here forever like I was with Twilight Princess, or that took from December to basically the beginning of June to finish. I don't want that happening again, because that is a terrible thing to happen, and when it does, it scares me because I don't think I'll ever get to another project, which is why I'm hoping this time people won't continuously die and make me have to restart the chapter. So stop dying. That's the one difficult thing about this entire game, is making sure nobody dies. Especially if you want to make sure, like, everybody's alive for the next game, because they're all technically alive in the next game. So if any of them die here, I assume, because I haven't been able to do it yet, because I haven't beaten this game on a normal or hard difficulty file yet, that they kind of die in Radiant Dawn, as in they are not there. And I don't want that to happen, because Radiant Dawn, as horrible as I think it is at the moment, because I've only got to Chapter 5, is really, really annoying. And I'd rather not have to sit there for hours on end when I can just use the characters from this game, because they'll actually be stronger than the ones in Radiant Dawn, because the Dawn Brigade is terrible. I'm just gonna hold the A button. Maybe that'll speed it up. I have no idea. At this point, I just want to get past all these battle phases, to which I may mess with the settings to make it not have to keep loading in and out of the battle sequence. However, I really don't want to do that since this is technically our first time in the chapter. I might save these kinds of things for the bosses and new enemies, though. I'm not so sure how I want to go about that yet. I might need to move Shinon over. Unless I can get Ike over there in the next couple of turns. You want to know how Boyd died in the last time I tried recording this? He took down several lancemen, and then when he fought against a swordsman... Well, no, he killed off 5 different lancemen. The boss threw a javelin at him, and then the swordsman came up and killed him. Because Boyd couldn't understand the concept of not having your enemy alive. You don't have an axe I'm looking for. Who has my axe? You have a regal sword. You have javelins. You have the axe I'm looking for. Okay, trade. Hand axe. That's not gonna kill the bowman. I don't know what I want to do. Yes, I do. Titania, kill. Don't you judge me, I have to have her kill people. It's the best way to get Gatry in front. I swear to God. This game. On normal mode, it's a bit of a pain. It's a pain on any of the difficulties if you want to keep everybody alive. That's basically all there is to it. To keep everyone alive, it is a pain in the butt. That's all there is to it, to be honest. But the thing is with this game, if you don't keep people alive, they end up dying, and then you end up having a smaller army because of it. And you want an army. You don't want to go into the final battle with 5 people. You don't want to do that, because then you'll just get mauled by 50 dudes. And I don't think 5 dudes can take 10 of them each. I should go up to you. Maybe hit you with a steel axe? Nope, I'm still gonna get hit anyway. Reese, heal please. Heal the person that got killed last time because he was reckless. Steel axe. Steel axe that archer in the face. Things that are going on about. Nothing, to be honest. I want to keep personal and current events out of these videos. Gonna probably have Ike over here for a bit. I don't want Oscar dying. But I also don't want Soren to get killed by a bow. Because Soren will get murdered by a bow if I have him over there. And I'm not so sure what to do with Soren at the moment, because I forgot what to do. Vulnerary, please. Thank you. Wait right there. Soren. 7x2. Take advantage of it. Because now he can get experience points. Thank goodness that wasn't a critical, otherwise he wouldn't have needed that. Then again, he didn't need that last thing either. I should probably end this up in about 10 minutes, because I want to make sure this blends into the into part 7. Which would make sense, to be perfectly honest. If I didn't do that, then I'd probably have a problem in my hands. Oh, you're going after Ike. Okay. You could have gone after Soren, but... yeah, go after the guy with 31 hit points. Good job. I remember my first playthrough, I gave the Seraph Robe to Soren rather than Ike. I don't know what compelled me to give it to Ike this time around. Oh, no wait. Yeah, I do. Normal mode. That's exactly why I gave it to Ike. Higher difficulties, that's why. You're going after him. How much did you do last time? I think it was like 5? 4. Perfect. Brilliant! You're gonna run away again. That's your MO. I might have Ike kill him, because Ike has a regal sword, and regal swords are pretty boss in that regard. Because the regal sword is only a one-time item for Ike. Once it's gone, it's gone. So you want to make sure you don't waste that. And by not wasting that, I mean don't have Ike use it up in this first half of the game. Otherwise, Ike will be left without a sword that can strike through knights and horsemen. If you do that, he's going to have to rely on the Armor Slayer for the knights, and he can't really harm the knights all that well. I mean, like, horseback knights. He won't be able to hurt mounted units all that well out the regal sword. So I'm going to keep that around for a bit. I might change him up to the steel sword that we have on him. Soren, killed the hammer dude. Because hammers are nasty. Hammers are effective against knights. Really quickly before we end off this part, I want to talk about weapons that are effective against certain types of classes. Hammers, they're strong against knights, and in later games, great knights. Mainly because they are heavily armored. Actually, we can just do this right now. It's good against armored foes like generals and knights in this game. In other games, they'll be good against great knights, since great knights have a less of a tendency to, well, move as fast as regular cavalry and paladins. Other than that, they're not too terrible as a weapon. They're fairly low in terms of an accuracy spike, so you won't be getting much of a hit on certain enemies. But I think at this point, if I can kill this guy, no I cannot. What I'm gonna do, have him in here. No wait. Vulnerary. And at this point, I'm gonna call it a Daein for this part, since this is still part 10, technically part 7. And we'll continue on to part 8 with this chapter, and hopefully nobody will die. Seriously, that is going to be the MO of this entire Let's Play. Nobody better die.